Hello and welcome to Take Time. I'm your host, Patrick Marlette, and let's talk about some new straps hitting the market. In this episode, I'm going to be discussing four brands that have made some serious changes to their strap lineup so you guys know what is currently available on the market. And in no particular order, I'm going to start with these guys here. You know I love Haveston. You've heard about them on the show before, and they made some serious changes to their strap lineup. There are two reasons in particular that I love this brand. One, they're always willing to listen to their consumers, and two, they actually listen to their consumers. So here we have a new canvas strap from the brand, and I've been asked numerous times, where can I buy a canvas strap? And I often didn't have an answer for that because I don't generally look for canvas straps, but now I can answer Haveston. The M1944 and quarterdeck seen here are two new options from Haveston. They come in at 18, 20, or 22 millimeters in width and measure about 275 millimeters in length with a total thickness of 1.5 millimeters. You can get these on either a brushed hardware or polished hardware setup. Now at 1.5 millimeters thick, these aren't gonna fit every watch, but here on my Shark Diver, it's no issue with clearance between the spring bar and the chassis, nor is it an issue with the M1944 seen here on my Pulsar. I really love the look of this new canvas strap when paired with this digital watch head. Also, you'll notice that there is a sliding keeper on these canvas straps. Similarly, to their M1936 and Invasion strap. Now, I'd say those are their most popular from their previous lineup, and this is actually the previous generation of the M1936 strap, and you'll notice that it is a two-piece construction. Well, of all the four brands I'll be discussing today, Haveston has gone through the most changes by modifying this to its new form. Here's the new M1936 strap from Haveston. Not only has the color tone changed, but here's what I'm talking about by how they listen to their consumers. Folks have been asking for a thinner strap. Well, guess what? Now the straps are 1.3 millimeters thick and single pass. So you don't get the added thickness of that secondary strap. And it is a much, much welcome change. And that's not the only thing that's changed. As a matter of fact, the sliding keeper has just a little bit more room to play on the strap itself. As you'll notice here, there's just a few millimeters more distance that this keeper can travel. The new Invasion and M1936 straps will come in at 18, 20, or 22 millimeters in width, will come with either polished, brushed, or black PVD hardware, and come at a length of 270 millimeters. Now these two straps, as well as their canvas counterparts, will come in at $28.55, and I think that's a pretty good deal for the quality of these straps. Now a lot has changed since I talked about this next company here on the channel, and Billy over at Moose Strap Company has done a lot to enhance the premium nylon strap they offer. Previously at 1.5 millimeters thick, these added a lot of height to your watch on the wrist. Well, now, instead of offering only the premium strap, now they offer the premium slim line. At 9 different color options, the premium slim comes in at either 20 or 22 millimeters in width, 290 millimeters in length, and a thin 1.2 or 2.4 millimeters thickness when doubled up on the watch head. Now, all of the Moose Strap offerings come in at a cool $20, which I think is the most bang for your buck amongst the four brands I'll be discussing today. Unfortunately, they only come with one hardware style, so if you don't like brushed stainless steel hardware, that's a shame. However, to sweeten the deal even more so, if you wanted to buy anything off of Billy's site, he's generously offered the promo code TAKETIME15 so that you can cut 15% off of your next purchase. So I'd advise you take advantage of that if you're looking to add some thinner NATO-style straps to your lineup. Of course, Barton, being the biggest of the bunch today, offer the most ridiculous lineup of new straps, and I'm happy to say they all weigh in at 1850. This is the new Barton Jetson, and though having little to do with a futuristic animated sitcom, is nothing short of stellar. You can buy these in 11 different colorways and 4 different widths, being 18, 20 seen here, 22 or 24 millimeters in width, and it comes in at a length of 270 millimeters. So that pretty much guarantees it will fit any wrist. Now, while they're certainly not the thinnest of the new offerings I'm talking about today, at 1.5 millimeters thick or 3 millimeters thick when doubled up behind your watch head, I do believe they offer the best range of options for the money. So if you wanted a good diversity of NATO style straps with a cloth keeper, this is a great way to go. Now, last but not least, we have our final new additions to the market. But here, little has changed. This is the PhenomeNato strap. At $40, these are the most expensive of the bunch, but I love these straps. I mean, I'm not gonna lie to you. Of all the straps I'm showing you today, these are the ones I wear most often. I find these in my rotation so frequently. I'm just a huge fan of this brand. When you're looking to buy a new nylon strap, you need to ask yourself one question. Do I deserve the best? If the answer is yes, you buy PhenomeNato. There is a difference in quality between this seatbelt style strap and your average strap. We still have two scales, short and long. Short being 290 millimeters in length and long being 335. I personally prefer the long length, which is what I wear, and which is the length you see here. They come in at 20 or 22 millimeters in width and have brushed or polished hardware like before. But now we have a variety of colors ranging from olive green, blue, dark blue, black, admiralty gray, bond, which is black with two gray parallel stripes, and beige. Also, we have a revised buckle with these new straps. Again, it's fixed to the strap like our previous model, but now with the PhenomeNato logo sitting proudly atop it. So altogether, not too much has changed here, but why, I ask you, would you mess with perfection? Now, working in reverse order, I want to show you guys just what these straps look like on the wrist. And this is the PhenomeNato in beige at long length on my 7.25 inch wrist. Of course, on top of that is my Christopher Ward. And here is the new Barton Jetson on my Haveston Shark Diver. You can see it adds a little bit of height to the watch, but it's not so dramatic when it's a tool watch. And I really do love the pairing with the gray and beige outline of the strap on this brass watch case. And here is the Moose strap in gray on my Christopher Ward. Again, you'll notice the top button here is going over top and under, as I don't have a sliding secondary keeper to keep it cinched down. This is just generally how I prefer to wear straps that don't have a sliding keeper. And at its new thickness, it has a nice profile on the wrist. Lastly, we have the two newest offerings from Haveston, starting with the canvas strap. And as you can see, the single pass makes a difference. These watch heads fit firmly against your wrist with very little height added. And I love that. Thank you, Haveston, for this change. So all of their straps now are single pass. If you look at their website, there's no more double straps. Also, everything has a sliding keeper, so you can keep the tail end of these straps cinched down as much as you'd like. And lastly, here is the new M1936, again on my Christopher Ward, and I absolutely love this color combo. As a matter of fact, you've likely seen this combination on my Instagram. I just think this looks smashing for this watch. The touch of green and shades of brown on the Haveston strap pair perfectly with that bronze case. Now, gang, that is it for our July strap roundup. If you found this video insightful or in the least entertaining, feel free to hit that like button. It looks a little something like this guy. If you have friends, forums, or groups that are interested in picking up a new nylon strap, well, share this video with them first so they can see what is new to the market. Also, if you are new to the channel, well, welcome. I do videos like this 2 or more times a week. So if you enjoy watch content, feel free to hit that subscribe button. It lets me know that you're down for the show. And if you'd like to see when my videos air precisely when they release, you can hit the bell icon just next to that. Again, my name is Patrick Marlette, and thank you for the time.